we are one of the most affordable physio departments in the country. We are almost at the moment charging almost less than half of what the others are doing, even with the quality that we have. Why? Because the idea of the founders of all these establishments is to actually bring excellence to and make it affordable to people who probably may not be able to afford it outside there, right? And so our treatments are very, very, very affordable. Even insurances, all insurances accept them, as far as I know right now, as I speak now. None of them can reject our services. Why? Because we made it very affordable and very quality. So like the For Life cases may not be for all the time visit. We also do what we call home visits. We go back home and train the attendants and tell you what to do. I told you we are never mean with information. Because what is our goal? For the patient recovery. We are patient-centered. So affordability is what we do here. We're talking about others charging. Now, the average price of physio today in Uganda speaking is about, on average, the 70 to 100,000. That's the range. Everywhere else. Here, we are half of that.
Why?
Because we are after the patients having affordability. Because the goal is to bring this thing affordable. So that what they could have failed to get, they now have the access. However, our quality is highest. With that affordability, our quality is highest. So we're trying to balance all this because we understand the economy here. Yeah, the quality is non-negotiable. It's non-negotiable. We are for excellence. Aga Khan is known for excellence. The investment is for excellence. And the results are evident. Everyone that has ever come to our services has always wondered. The only shocker they will be like, I thought I was going to pay like 10 times what I pay somewhere else. Well, they made it deliberately affordable. Now, we shall go with the economy as we grow, all right? But at the moment, we are giving that privilege. And that moment is a prolonged moment. It's not for a short time. Why? Because we are patient-centered. Our goal is to improve quality of life for our people. Now, when we do that, they will refer other patients. Actually, most of my referrals today are from former patients. Former patients. Of course, I receive from other hospitals, but former patients will tell you, you want to get well, go to the Aga Khan Metroplex Mall, Nalia. They will come here. And that has been one of our pride, you know. We love that patients are actually our agents. So we don't want this, I went there and man, I'm broke now because of going to Aga Khan. So that notion is, we don't want to hear it. It doesn't sound good to us. It's better that they refer others. You want to get well, go to the Aga Khan. So that's our priority.
Just out of curiosity, do you also offer some free services to those who perhaps totally don't have money, but they need this kind of service and they're in desperate need?
Now, that one is a case-by-case issue. It's not a policy issue. Yeah, because we, at the end of the day, we need to sustain our establishment. And so we do not have that as a policy. However, it can be a case-by-case where we probably just sponsor that as a unit or as healthcare providers, and we're like, okay, for this patient, cannot afford, cannot do this, let's get our resources together and help. But as a policy, as now, we don't. And that's part of the reason why we reduced the prices so that as many people as possible can afford. Yeah, I mean, if you're paying 42,000 shillings, and that is what you would do, you would have to multiply that times 3 to get one session elsewhere. So that's a good deal. That's a good deal for anyone. So we don't have free services by policy here. Yes.
Let me just take you back again to something you said about ignorance. And when you were responding, you talked about educating people deliberately so that they know about physiotherapy.
That's right.
I don't know if you also go out just deliberately, like do maybe, can I call them outreaches?
Outreaches, yes.
And teach
outreaches.
People about physio, maybe demonstrate, maybe help a few people in the community so that they get the knowledge, and then maybe next time they can just come, they know there is this service they can come and get.
That is so true. And well, I want to really appreciate because the management, because they have given us that opportunity to reach out. We go to camps, medical camps. Some of them are organized by us, some of them are not, but we will take our knowledge there. So TV shows, radio, we've been there. I think there was a time that we've gone with her to several radio stations, including Dembe, Capture FM. We've been there, trying to cause awareness that, look, you don't need to die with this. I mean, you don't need to live with this disability. You don't need to do, there is help available at the Aga Khan establishment here in Uganda. So yes, we do that. And we organize our own outreaches. We do that quite a bit. And we've also been going to, I told you about occupational health, right? So one of the things that we've done also corporately, these corporate companies, like Total, I think I remember Total, I remember this bank here, the bankers. So they would call us and we go and actually do health education on ergonomics. Eh? Ergonomics is the way you should sit, the way you should arrange your chairs. I talked about these things. So yes, that education is ongoing. And it's part of our services. It's part of our services. So, but also what we're doing now is part of that, right? So that the people out there should get to know not only what we have, but to appreciate that you can have a better quality of life free of disability if you access these services. You don't need to have a prolonged back pain post C-section. 6 months, 8 months, 1 year, you're still having pain. No, we can fix that in a matter of days. What physiotherapy does is to help you to the maximum function possible. Maximum function possible. For example, if you got a really bad stroke and the whole leg is paralyzed and you can't do anything. Physio, our first goal for achievement is that, can this person do self-care? Can we help him to walk, to sit, to go to the toilet, to eat by themselves? Once we achieve that, for us, we've hit the maximum goal. You may not go back to playing football, okay, like you used to do 20 years back. Eh? Now, that one is magic. But we will take you to the maximum possible function available with every help that we have. So it depends on the conditions. It depends on the effect of that injury, whether it's an injury or an infection. And so limitations, yes. We can't take you, for example, degenerative features now. Your back is eaten up, the bones are what and all that, the discs are degenerated. We can't take it back to where it used to be. But with that degeneration, we can help you to function. We avoid the disability part of it so that it doesn't disable you. You're able to do what we call activities of daily living. You're able to move around. You're able to sit. You're able to walk. That, to us, is the goal. So when you talk about the limitations, we will set the goals. So it is goal-oriented. So we'll tell you, based on this condition of yours, this is the goal we can achieve. Then we agree with the patient. So what is the goal? You to walk. Not to run, to walk. So we work towards that goal. Once you walk, we know we have ticked that one. Then we assess again, can they go past walking to running? If the condition doesn't allow that, we tell you this is the maximum possible function that we can do. Okay? Then we let you be like that. Now, I didn't tell you the other things, like orthopedic, like amputations. Yeah, we prepare that for, then we prepare you, train you to get an artificial limb and all that. That's part of physio. And so now, letting you have that example, so we can't grow back that leg, but we can help you have another artificial leg that can be functional enough for you to walk around, for you to do your daily work minus pain. So we make sure we do that. So it is based on goals. The limitations are those which are beyond the goals. We don't want to set ambitious goals beyond the capacity of physiotherapy. Now, physiotherapy is, like I said earlier, it's a healthcare profession. Eh? And if anything to do with function, loss of function, or delayed function, or distorted function, and mobility, even if you take how many drugs and you buy a whole pharmacy, you will not walk until you come for physiotherapy. All the other doctors will send you to a physio, will tell you look for a physiotherapist. Probably the common is they may not pinpoint what they should do, they'll just tell you go for physio. So yes, there are things that can never be fixed except by physio, especially to do with function restoration or improvement, quality of life, activities of daily living, and mobility. If you want to move ever again after your illnesses, you will definitely need our services. And these services are now becoming very crucial. The World Health Organization is now putting emphasis on it in these next decades. And to incorporate it in every department mandatorily all over the world, because they saw the need. Why should you heal from a fracture and you can't flex your knee? You have a stiff knee. Why? Okay, so you just have to know that this is part of your treatment. Especially women ignore that until the pain doesn't go away. Then it's like, okay, oh, we've tried, I've taken medicine, I've taken all these things. And they say, okay. Usually they say, you try physio. So I'm here to tell you that don't just try. Make it part of your treatment goals. All right? Because it's part and partial of your well-being. For now, we have 300 We are not many. Okay? We are few. We have few training centers for physio now. We have one at Mulago, Ekure, and Mbarara, I think, yeah. Makerere doesn't have it as yet. So there are many universities that have not yet picked up this. But we are a growing profession in the country. Compared to our counterparts in the region, there are now quite many, but for us, we are not so many. So physios are not so many. So you might go to a hospital and there is no physiotherapist. And so they will just tell you, look for one, or they will just tell you, go and go home, okay? But in the government setting, there are physios in regional referral hospitals. At least you get physios there in our structure. But below that, below regional referrals, there are no physios. There are no physios at district level. There are no physios there yet because we can't afford, I don't know, the numbers. Eh? We can't have, and many of them are on private practice. So yes, we are few, but here we are more than enough to handle. We are many here.
Or you can go to the government facility.
Yeah, government facility has physios at regional referral hospital. Yes, and national referral, which is Mulago. Now, the uniqueness about us is more of our patient care policy here. At our establishment here, we stick to the multidisciplinary approach. Okay? We work with specialists. This is a one-stop center for specialists. So when you come for physio, you have access to every other specialist that you can ever get your hands on, as long as it is related to your condition. So that one is a very big plus. Not many centers have that access. Two, we are committed to evidence-based practice. We don't do things that don't work. We do things that have been proven over the years to have worked with results. And we stick to that as a matter of policy. Two, we are patient-centered. not money-centered. So we are after, that has the patient improved? We are after, have they gone out of, you know, where have we taken them from, which direction? So this is something that sets us apart. So you'll not fear that, oh, these people are going to squeeze money out of me and all that. What you should be happy about is you're going to get well when you come to us. Why? Because we shall work towards that as a goal. Then the other one, yes, there is a heavy investment, state-of-the-art equipment that we have, that definitely other people probably may not be able to have. I can assure you that. And so with that, it gives us leverage to be able to have an advantage over the others. And because we want to be the pioneer of excellence in the country, I think we have that edge over the others. And that one I can tell you for a matter of fact.
How long has this place been in your place?
This has been since 2014.
Oh. Yeah. How many years is that?
I think it's now, this is the seventh year, I think, possibly, yeah. Yes, so it's been a journey. We are learning, we are doing all these other things, but you come and we grow together, yes. Let the patients, let them be part of the family. This is a family kind of best arrangement that we have. We want you to be part of our family so that we can be healthy and live long and have quality life and enjoy our country.
Well, thank you so much, Joel Oriem, for your time. We have been at the Aga Khan University Hospital, Metroplex Medical Center, Nalia, discussing matters of physiotherapy. Well, if you think your health is not good enough and you need your health restored, look for Joel Oriem at the Aga Khan University Hospital, Metroplex Medical Center, Nalia, and you'll have your issues sorted. I have been your host, Jackie Chan. Until next time, goodbye.